Hey BookTube, it's Emily. I told you I was going to start posting regularly again, and here I am, two videos in a week. Ta-da! In today's video, I want to talk about Monuments by Will Kostakis, which is the newest release by this author. It's a urban fantasy. His first two books were contemporary, so this is a bit of a departure, but I think it was a good one. I actually went to the book launch here in Canberra for this book, and while admittedly I haven't been to a lot of book launches, this was one of the best ones that I've attended. Will Kostakis is really entertaining, he's a really good speaker, and he was also very open not just about his writing process but about events in his life which have really informed his writing. As I mentioned, Will's first two books are both contemporary books, and in his own words, they are issue books. They drew quite heavily on experiences from his own teenage years and growing up, and he found that incredibly draining. So his solution to that was to write a book that was fun and adventurous and basically all the things he liked as a teenager. And the result of that was Monuments. Monuments is the story of Connor, who is a gay Greek Australian teenager who accidentally discovers a god buried under his school in Sydney. So Connor ends up on an adventure with a girl called Sally, whom he's not sure he can trust, and later on a very gorgeous guy called Lockie. And the three of them have to uncover the other four gods in the pantheon and stop these gods' enemies from crossing over into our world and destroying life as we know it, basically. There's a bit of everything in this book. There's magic, there's action, there's secrets, there's romance, there's really deep emotions and feelings, there's banter, and there's even time travel. If Will Kostakis set out to write a fun book, then he definitely succeeded in that goal. I do have to admit I was a little bit dubious going in, basically because I was thinking, why would there be gods buried in Sydney? If they've been buried for a long time, why would anybody have chosen that spot? But that's actually addressed because Connor has exactly the same question. So once that was sort of explained, it is a good explanation and I was happy with that, so away I went with the story. I was sucked in. I have to admit that I got a bit lost with all the time travel. There's sort of a section where they're time hopping all over the place and I completely lost track. But because it happened far enough into the book that I was already invested, I was happy to sort of let it slide, and everything calmed down again after a few chapters. So I just sort of rolled with it and just kept having fun. I want to talk about Connor, the protagonist. I was on his side straight away. He's a bit of a nerd, but he's also really sassy. And once Lockie shows up as well, there's some great back and forth between the two of them. Not to mention, they are a really super cute couple. And I really liked how casual the book was about them being gay. At the book launch, Will talked about how he wasn't sure how explicit to be about the fact that Connor was gay, to the point where he wasn't even sure he should mention it at all. But fortunately, he had some really supportive publishers who encouraged him to be really open about that in the text. So instead of something being really subtexty, you've got this great scene where Connor is asked if he's Sally's date and to an event, and he was like, "What? No, I'm super gay." And there's even kissing, and did I mention that it's super cute? This is a duology, and the second book, which is called Rebel Gods, comes out next August. This one wraps up pretty satisfactorily. Like, obviously there's set up for the events in the next book, but you don't feel like you've been left hanging at the end of Monuments, which is really good. I don't like really big cliffhangers, and I didn't feel like this one ended on one. I've actually got one of Will's other books, The First Third, out from the library at the moment. I haven't actually read either of his contemporary novels, so I'm really interested to see how this one compares to Monuments in terms of tone and content, that sort of thing. And there will definitely be another video where I talk about my thoughts on The First Third, so watch out for that one, and bye for now.